Hey, this is Frank, and you're watching the DIY Engineer channel. This is the first battery pack of three that I'll be building in the upgrade of my portable power pack. This battery here consists of a 40P 4S configuration. And in this video, we're gonna go over bus bars, BMS, and fusing. Hey, this is Frank, and this is the DIY Engineer channel. And on this channel, we do everything do-it-yourself. So if you're into creating things, fixing stuff, making things better, then this is the channel for you. Please subscribe below and leave any comments that you might have. Be sure and ding the little bell or just click on it. And that way there you will be notified whenever we have video updates or new videos are released. So let's get into first, the bus bars of this power pack. All right, so what we're looking at here is this first battery pack. And if you look really closely, you can see that this row of cells here, these two rows here are negative, then we have positive, then we have negative, positive. So negative, positive, negative, positive. And what the plan is, because I'm gonna be using a BMS, this is a tiny one, and I'm hoping I didn't underrate it. This is a 30 amp. I should be okay because I'm going to be using three of these, and the most I'll ever push through it is 100 amps. So that's actually going to push up a little over 30, and I may need to upgrade these to 40 amp, but that won't be a problem because I'll already have all the wiring in place. And these were cheap, so if I burn them up, it's not that big of a deal. It's kind of an experiment because I've never used BMSs before, never. So this is a good experiment for me. So I'm going to be using some wire, just some regular household wire, and the plan is to just run strips down the center of the negative, down the center of the positive, down the center of the negative, and down the center of the positive. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie these two cell groups together and these two cell groups together on this side. Then we're going to do the same thing on the other side, but I'm only going to tie the center together. So that way there we get a flow. So what I mean by a flow is if you look at this from this perspective here, this here is being positive, and so the energy, and this over here is negative, so, and they're gonna be on the top. So what's gonna happen is the energy is gonna flow down through the cell, then up through these cells, down through these cells, and up through these cells. So we'll have a good flow. Now, one of the other things that I like to make sure that I'm covering is that when I run juice, some guys will actually put their ends on the same end. So they'd have a hangover on this side, not a drunken hangover, but a hangover of wire. And they'll hang their positive lead off of here, whether it's a bus bar or a bracket, and then they'll have the negative on this side. Well, I don't like doing that because I like to have the juice run through the full pack, kind of in this manner. And so what I would do is I would put a positive up here out of this corner, but I would run my negative out the bottom on this side. So that way there's always flow through all the cells, even though they're tied together in series or in parallel. What I'm gonna do, and in series, what I'm gonna do is make sure that that energy flow is hitting all of the cells and not just the, you know, the top being hit and then drawing down into the cells as far as I can. There has been some, people have created some videos where there's been some issues with doing it that way. So I'm gonna run across my cells. Now then, so I have a BMS, we're gonna use some wire. This is not the wire, this here is not the wire I'm gonna use. I'll be showing you the wire here in a minute. And fusing, I've actually just seen what others have done, and a lot of times people will use fuse wire like this. These are just resistors, and all you do is you cut the resistor out of the center and use the wire between. Now, I have actually tested this and I've seen other tests done, and it has worked out very well. Anytime you get over 4 amps running out of one of these cells, it fries the wire. The wire just burns. And so that's all I'm looking to do, is just to have some sort of protection. It doesn't have to be perfect, because I'm gonna actually fuse both sides. So every single joint in this battery will have a fuse. So if something were to happen, if I have a cell that goes rogue, or if for some reason it gets shorted out or crossed, it's only going to be shorted for a short period of time because it's going to fry those fuses. So that's the big part of that. Now, let's go out to the garage and I'm going to show you how I harvest, because this is all about harvesting, right? How I harvest my bus bars, my wire for these cells. So let's go.
So I got a hold of some old wiring. Actually, this is my daughter and son-in-law bought a house and they had it rewired. And the house was built back in the 50s, so it's an older home. And so I have some of this old wire that they were just gonna throw out. I thought, hey, there's good copper in there. Let's see if I can use some of it. So I'm gonna see if I can strip some of this and use it. So what I did is I have there's a razor blade inside my vise here that I'll use to draw across. I just have to be careful not to injure myself because that blade is really sharp. But we're gonna try and see if I can't strip off some of this housing without doing any damage to the copper itself or to myself.
Cool, wasn't it, where you get these now I have these really cool bus bar wires that are all twisted and nice and straight from that old those old wires. So what I'm going to do, the plan is now to take these, and all I need to do is cut my lengths so I have good straight cut lengths for doing my wiring. Oop, there it goes. I'll make sure that's good and straight. And I just need enough to catch my fuses on this pole. So I'm going to cut this one right about here. So there I have my first bus bar. So I'm just going to create, I have to have, so 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. So let me just grab my wire here and we'll just cut 4 of those puppies just the same length so they're nice and consistent. You know me, Mr. OCD, doing things overkill. But that's just how it is, right? So now I have my 4 bus bars for this side. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And then I'm going to need to do the same thing on the other side. And you're probably saying, well, you cut them all short. You don't have any overhang, nothing to hook onto. Well, we're going to actually use wire. I'm actually going to solder on my connections with some braided wire. And it's going to just, one, to make it a little neater, and two, mainly because I'm going to be using a BMS. And so I'm not hooking these packs together. I'm tying them into a BMS. And that BMS will handle all of the juice. So there's four for this side, and then I need to do another four for the other side. So I got four more to create. I need a total of 8. Okay, so now I've cut a total of 8 bus bars for this battery, in which I'm going to put 4 on each side. And let me explain this again. After I have the 4, what it's going to do is these cell types are going to be put together. So let me get these out of the way. So we have on this end over here, we have negative. So all of these cells will tie to this bus bar, and these are all positive, and they'll tie to this bus bar, negative, positive. Okay, and then I'm going to run jumpers across. So how that's going to work is between these cells, here and here, I'll probably skip 4 and do another bus bar and another bus bar. I'm going to have little bus bars that go across here to tie these cell packs together, and nothing in this middle. So this will be blank. Reason is because that's on the other side. And we're going to do the same over here, and then the other end will actually be my positive and negative. So by putting those bus bars across here, I'll be able to have consistency, and I'll be able to have good energy flow across all of those. So what we're going to do to fuse these cells is I'll take these fuses, or these resistor wires. This is kind of hard to see because these things are tiny, but we'll solder them across so that they hold down each of these cells. So it's going to go across the cells like that, and we're going to get rid of the little resistor in the middle. And so this is actually, it's going to cover 4 cells just with this one wire. All right, so now I got to get to work on that part. I will video some of the soldering that I'm going to do on here, but sitting and watching me solder for hours on end is not the funnest thing in the world, and you don't want to waste your time doing it, and I don't want to waste your time doing it. So I'll shoot that separately, and I'll probably put it on time lapse. If you have an interest in watching soldering going on, you can do that, but I think you'll find better things to do with your time. Oh, and just for the fun of it, I'm going to play a little bit of my reskinning video for all of these cells at the very end, so you can watch me reskin them. Woohoo! Yay! Later.